गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज दिशा हितल, अश्वमिक विद्यालय, जिला पाड़ी, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, स्टैंडर्ड 7, चैप्टर नंबर 2। द क्रीचिंग वेंट ऑन एंड ऑन। व्हाट्स दैट नॉइज, सेड मृदु। दैट्स लाली लर्निंग टू प्ले द वायोलिन, ग्रांटेड वन देवी। सी विल नेवर लर्न अ थिंग। द म्यूजिक मास्टर जस्ट गोज ऑन प्लेइंग लाइक अ ट्रेन, विसिंग ऑन एंड ऑन, व्हाइल लाली इज ऑल द टाइम रियलिंग, गोइंग कंप्लीटली ऑफ ट्रैक। ही रिमाइंडेड मृदु कैट्स बीइंग वर्शिप इन एंशिएंट इजिप्ट, ही बिलीव टू बी अ डिसेंडेंट टू कैट गॉडेस। बास्केट, दे हियर स्क्रैच एंड लेटर रियलाइज that it was Lali learning to play the violin. Comprehension. First question, what is the secret that Meena shares with Mridu in the backyard? Question 1-5. I write the note PDF and send you a PDF, and then you will write the notebook. Part 2. Mridu crept up to the window. Lali was sitting a little distance away, awkwardly holding her violin and bowstring. Her elbows jut out and her eyes glazed with constriction. The elderly music master was expert of playing on the violin, but Lali could not construct on learning it. He had a mostly plaid heard with a fringe of oiled black hair falling around his ears and an old fastened topped. A gold chain gleamed around his leathery neck and a diamond ring glittered on his hand as it glided up and down the stem of the violin. Then they heard a wail of beggar from the gate. Hearing this, Ravi's mother from the kitchen cries out to Ravi and to ask the beggar of his excuse to come daily to ask alms. Following the order to go away, he was ready to leave, but he requested to allow him to rest under that tree as there was scorching heat and the tree. A large foot stuck out from beneath his gold border vesti edge, and he was beating time on the floor with the scraven big toe. He played a few notes. Lali stumped behind him on her violin, which looked quite helpless and unhappy in her hands. What difference? The music master notes seemed to float up and settle perfectly into the invisible tracks of the melody. He showed his blistered feet to the children and pleaded them to allow him to stay back. Talking pity on, the children decided to give him a pair of chappals, but there were no too small to fit his feet. Mridu started at that huge ring hang moving effortlessly up the violin stem, making lovely music. Back there was a Lali dealing again. Amma came a wail from the gate. Amma, oh, Ravi, send that beggar away, cried his mother from the back veranda where she was chatting. He has been coming here every day for the past week, and each time he found another house to beg from. Patti explained to Tapi. Mridu and Meena followed Ravi out. The beggar was already in the garden making himself quite at home. He had spread his upper cloth under the neem tree and was leaning against its trunk, apparently prepared to take a little snooze. While he waited for the alarms to appear, "Go away," said Ravi sternly. "My Patti says it's time you found another house to beg from." The children decided to give him a pair of chappals, but these were too small to fit his feet. So they started searching for a suitable one. They found such a pair belonged to the music master, which was lying on the veranda. They picked them and gave away to the beggar, and the beggar left. Now after the teaching session was over, the music master started searching for missing pair chappals. The beggar opened his eyes with very wide and gazed at each of children one by one. "The ladies of this house," he said at last in a voice choked with feeling, "are very kind souls. I have kept my body and soul together on their generosity for a whole week. I cannot believe that they would turn me away." He raised his voice. "Amma, Amma, oh," said his voice might be, but it certainly wasn't fit well. It began in a deep, stronger rumble somewhere in his withered belly and came booming out of his mouth with its few remaining teeth stained brown with betel chum. Lali and Rukumani also joined the search. Then Ravi declared the fact he had given away to the beggar. His mother got angry with Ravi. Then she fought hardly one new chappals. Ravi tell him there's nothing left in the kitchen called Ruku and Mani, and it's not good. Come again, tell him that she sounded fed up. And then part 2 and part 3 आगे का हम नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में देखेंगे. थैंक यू.